Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to episode 24 of our Volt Hunters Let's Play. The plan for today's episode is, of course, running a couple of volts so we can try and unlock Botania. I think I'm going to just run volts until I unlock Botania. I got the next couple of days off, so there may not be the most content in this one as far as, like, I'm not going to add every volt is what I mean on that. But I'm going to add, like, the more interesting things. If we get, like, a really good volt with a couple of gilded runs, I'll definitely include that. But for the most part, if I just get, like, a random old volt, probably won't even add it. Maybe add me entering it and leaving it just so y'all know, you know, I didn't cheat anything in or anything like that. But I'm going to get all of our crystals ready. I think I still have a couple left over from last episode. Yeah, I got two left over, and I do have this one. Still have not been able to find anything extra on it, besides, you know, the plentiful and stuff like that. But other than that, nothing really too crazy. I mean, I could obviously put safe zone on it, which would definitely help, but just that one set of gilded really isn't the best thing to run with. So I'm gonna run those crystals through a couple catalysts, see if I get anything better, and I'll be back. Alright, so to start it off, I'm gonna just do this little safe zone gilded and lucky one that I have put up. Like I said, I'm not gonna show the entire vault. I know it gets kind of repetitive, but I want to try and get as many catalyst fragments. I know this one won't have any, but the next vault that I can, because all my rolls in there were just no good. So I'll be back if I find anything interesting. Alright, we're coming back to the portal. I got a couple of the obelisks, but wasn't really focused on that. So let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. I do know we got a couple of old diamonds. I kind of showed when a chest had it. I just wanted to open it up and show that on camera. But I didn't show them all, so I'm actually not sure how many we do have. We got 15 from that. That's really, really good. And 49 star essence, so that's already another knowledge star. I actually think I can craft two knowledge stars because I had quite a bit of, I think I had 7 volt diamonds beforehand. Yeah, so let's go ahead and craft up a couple of volt diamond blocks. I have enough for 2, I think I do. And now I gotta just craft up some, where is it at? I'm just gonna mark it real quick. Did I skip it? I think I did. Let's see where, here it is. So we'll mark that right over here. Craft up a couple of perfect Lurimore. Should just need 8 of them. Star cores, 2 of those right now, and then after that, nice, so 2 more knowledge stars, brings our total up to 9, we just need 2 more, we're not very far off to be honest. How many volt diamonds do I have? I have 4 left, so yeah, just a couple of more, so I think we'll definitely have Botania unlocked by the end of this episode. I'm gonna clear out my danks, and I'll be back. Alrighty, now let's introduce a straight random volt, hopefully we get some good modifiers, maybe a gilded or horde would be nice. Okay, I'm not gonna complain about that at all. So now I'll be able to insta break the chest. So just be a couple if I get any. I'll just show me a couple breaking a couple on camera. Alright, we were fortunate enough to get a portal room this round, which is really, really good. Of course, one has to always explode. If this would have had safe zone, this would have been an insane run, because I've already gotten quite a bit of trap chests. That's like my 5th explosion one. I just haven't been showing them on camera because it's kind of boring. Alrighty, check it out, guys. This one has not one, but 2 portal rooms if you look on the minimap. So that's insane. It's insanely lucky. No explosion, which is good. I'd have poison any day. And my idol broke. Never mind. Alrighty, time for the second portal room. Let's hope we don't get an explosion. My luck, we probably will. No good deal. And none were trapped either, which is always good to see. Alright, time's running out. Let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. I do want Joseph's opinion. I want you to comment down below right now. Pause the video and tell me, do you think we got more Volt Diamonds this run than the last run? We got 15 last run, so let's see what we did this round. I can tell you we did see a lot in those chests as I was breaking them. 28 Volt Diamonds in over a stack and a half stars. So yeah, we can definitely unlock Botania. That's going to give us something to do for the rest of the episode. I am super, super hyped about that. Only 7 Catalyst Fragments, which is kind of, it's okay. And we did get a lot of Volt Gear and 2 Echo Ore. I mean, Echo Gem, which is always good to have. That's an insane run right there. So that's the gear that we got that hasn't been sorted into my dank. And then we have a whole bunch more in here, and along with 6 traders. Let's get all these out because we might actually get a knowledge star from one of these. It's rare, but it can happen. Volt Essence. So it did not happen that round, but that's completely fine. And then a lot of traders, gifter statues, I should say. Let's go ahead and put these in our cryo chamber. I think we're getting pretty close to another eternal. I'm hoping we are, because it looks like I can't even hardly see the top anymore. So just in case it does happen on camera, I'm going to go ahead and put them all in there. Maybe not, unless that's the last one I need. Oh, nice. Just enough. So let's see what we get. Comment down your username below. Or actually, this one's going to be Valwater. He wanted one a while back. I'll put the comment right here if I can find it. And we're going to go Taunt 3. We're definitely giving you Taunt 3. And let's go ahead and level you up. Let's get a couple burgers out because I know I have some. And we can also level up the rest of our buddies downstairs. So let's do that. And I think you got a shit. So this one's going to, right here, is going to be Valwater because he has been commenting, like I said, one of those last episodes. And we'll go ahead and make another cryo chamber just in case. Let's get this block also. And we'll add you downstairs with the rest of our army, and we'll get you some good gear that we can put on you. That Taunt 3 right there is insane. Let's level you up. Got you all the way. Level you up as well. And I'm just going to put them all into health because, you know, really they die so quick. That extra health does help out quite a bit. You know. Oh, that was a good one. Awesome right there. We'll get you some armor here in a minute. Alrighty, I got my danks cleared out. Let's go ahead and craft up the rest of this stuff. I'm just going to craft the 2. Just like that. Craft a couple of Volt Diamond blocks. I think I can make 3 in total because I have 33 Volt Diamonds. But this is fine. Just go ahead and do it how we can. That way it's less stuff on the screen also. 1, 2. And just like that. Let's do it together, guys. Come on. Oh, wrong one. Botania has now been unlocked. So I have some huge plans for that. I'm going to kind of get into it today. You know, get the basic mana generation and show you how to do a nice auto, the stone and wood. That way that can be all automatically gathered and put into like a barrel, and I have an excess flow of that. But yeah, let's get everything together and let's just hop straight into Botania. Alrighty, guys, I got pretty much everything situated. For now, I'm gonna just start Botania out here. I plan on moving it either somewhere, building a base around it, or do y'all think I should build like a little basement for it? That's what I did in my old single player world, and it was alright. But as far as a Gaia Guardian fight, I always had to go somewhere else. But I'm going to kind of just show you all the basics. So you always want to start off by collecting flowers. You can find those pretty much scattered all over the world. You see right here we have a brown one. But what I think is the easiest thing to do, and it only requires a little bit of bones. Come right here. Put that in here. I got this. So I'm going to show you a cool little trick. This floral fertilizer. It takes bone meal and then any kind of dye. I typically use like white dye like this. You get that from bone meal. Just make as much as you can pretty much. And just like this. Over here, craft all of this stuff up, and you see, got me a good bit. You do this and it actually spawns all the different flowers that you could possibly get, and you just collect it like this. And then what I personally would do and recommend is, oh, actually let me do this one more time because I'm gonna need a petal. This flower pouch right here, it collects all the different flowers without taking up inventory space. So you do that, come over here. It only costs wool and any color petal. Does not matter the color. Craft one of those, and you can see right here when I open it, it shows you how many you have. And this is kind of how I wish danks were, that it had a 0 over there. And I always put my magnet on when doing this because it just makes it easier when collecting. And then pretty much just spam this a couple of times until you get all the different flowers. And then once you have one of each, you can actually automate this. Or pretty close to automated. It's still, you know, semi-auto. But you just get as many as you can. So once I get all the flowers, I'll be right back. Alrighty, you can see I have one of each flower at least, and since I have the least amount of brown, I'm going to show you how to kind of automate this. You can get one of these petals and actually plant it, just like this. And then if you have some bone meal, which we'll get right now, I think it only takes one. You can hit it with some bone meal and it grows. So if you see I break it, will not give me anything. You have to use shears. And then a cool little farm that I actually got from Chosen Architect. You go like this, you put the petal that you want to duplicate in there. You fill this other one up with some bone meal. Get a couple stacks out. Put that in here. And then if you have RF utilities unlocked, this is super, super simple. Just like this. You'll put a timer facing upwards. Oh. Sorry about that. And we're going to set it to pause while Rudson is active. And we'll probably set it to about, I think he did 5 ticks. Just like that. And then over here, the same exact thing. Pause while Rudson is active. Come over here and put 5. Not 50. Let me see. There we go. Pause. One moment. Alright, there we go. This one just for some reason was not clicking on there. But I put 2 torches there. A redstone dust here. You can then dig up. You have to leave these blocks empty. Put a couple of these. And then put a pressure plate. You can then come over here and hold your shears. Let's go ahead and just for the demonstration purposes put all these in there. Step on here. And you can just continuously break them like this until you have as many as you currently need. And then the cool thing about these tall flowers, you do this and you actually get 4 per instead of just a 2 per. So it comes, if you have, as long as you have one, you'll be able to duplicate it pretty fast. The first couple of them might be tedious having to constantly craft them and put them back in here. But after you get about 16 of them or so, it goes by pretty, pretty good. The next thing I want to do is craft up a Lexico Botania, what is it called? Lexico Botania, sorry about that. It's just a sapling or even a petal or a flower or anything like that. And then we're going to craft up a petal apothecary. It requires either a perfect biniotite or a perfect Lurimor and any petal. Craft up one of those. It's pretty much all you really need. And then I do not have modular routers unlocked, so I constantly have to just right click this. Unless y'all know another way down below that I can do with the current mods that I do have unlocked. And with that, this is what you're going to basically use like your crafting station for Botania. We want to start off by crafting a pure daisy. As you can see, it takes 4 white and either a perfect Lurimor or biniotite. So we'll come in here and actually we'll grab a couple of these white ones. I'm going to craft up 2 of these. And then you need seeds as well. So you get a couple seeds. I just get a stack of them. And then some perfect. I have a couple of these already at hand. And all you're going to do is drop however many you're going to end up. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this one. And you can see all you have to do now is drop a seed in there. And the cool thing about this is if you already have water back into it, you can right click it with an empty hand. And just like that. Just drop another seed in there, and it basically looks like if you're crafting really, really tedious recipes that require runes and all that, that's really good to do it, so you don't have to drop each and everything. And then with these pure daisies, I said I'm about this far apart, you're going to grab any kind of log. Typically, since I have a lot of oak, I'll use oak. And then in my dank over here, I have some stone. It has to be stone, can't be regular like cobblestone, but you'll do this. And after some time, it'll transmute into what it needs to be. Alright, and you can see after some time, it'll go ahead and convert over to living rock and living wood. You can then vein mine that if you'd like, or mine it one by one. And just basically do the same thing over again, because you're going to need quite a bit of this stuff. This is what you use for like your wand and your mana pools and stuff like that. And you're going to, later on down the line, probably about mid-Botania, you want to have like a mana battery, which is a whole bunch of mana pools being sent over mana from like 4 mana pools using nodes, I think that's what they're called. And it's just basically a really, really fast way of transferring mana. So now what we're going to do, now that we have a couple of these living rocks, we're going to come over here and craft up a, what is it called, mana pool. So we'll look up a mana pool, and you can see it's going to cost either a perfect Lurimor or a biniotite. I have some biniotite, so I'm going to just craft one up for now. And there's a couple different ways of making early game mana. One is an endo flame, which is what typically most people tend to use. there are also, I think they're like little sunflowers that generate mana when it's when there's sun outside, and then there's some like the moon equivalent to where it'll generate mana when it's nighttime, and that's just all passive mana, but they're really really slow. So a lot of people tend to use this Endo Flame, which I'll show you how to craft right now. It's gonna be 2 brown petals, a red petal, and a gray petal. So what we'll do is we'll come in here. I'm glad I crafted up some of these brown petals. Some red, and then some, was it gray or light gray? Light gray, okay. So we'll get some of this light gray as well. And I'll probably start off by crafting about 5 of them. That's typically what I tend to do, and eventually I end up adding more. But it's pretty much the same thing as before, which is a different recipe. 2 of these, 1 of these, and 1 of these. You can see right there, I just need the seed, and then I get an Endo Flame. So I'll do the same thing here. I'll craft all that up. Oop, not what I wanted to do. That's okay. Just a happy little accident. Put that there, right click it, and boom, just like that. So with these, oh wait, that's right, I want to craft 5, I'm sorry. Alrighty, now that I have those 5, I'm going to put them right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And right now they're not doing anything. I can throw some fuel on them. That fuel is probably not going to go anywhere. You can see they don't even want to pick it up. And that's because I need a wand and a mana spreader to send this mana over to this mana pool. So to craft up a wand, you need some of this living wood. And the cool thing about the wand is there's semi-customizable. You can use any color leaves. I typically use yellow just because it's my favorite color. You need any 2 leaves, and I'll just craft a crafting table out here, even though I have that little remote. But with this, I want to say you need 3 of these, and you'll put them this way, almost like you're making a fishing pole. Maybe it's just 2. One moment. Sorry about that. I forgot that I need a biniotide. I'm used to the vanilla recipe, or I say vanilla, but the normal Botania recipe. So it'll be either biniotide or Laramore right there. And this is what I was talking about with semi-customizable. Well, normally these will change colors. Like I said, I keep mine as yellow. And I guess they stay as white, so that's okay. But in the normal Botania, if you're playing like on a non-Volt Hunters one, it'll correlate to whichever one you have. Like if I had a brown here and a white here, this one would be brown and this one would be white. And now we also need a mana spreader, which we also use living wood for. And later on down the line, there's ways to upgrade your mana spreaders. There's like Gaia mana spreaders and just like this. So these ones are basically what I'm going to make right now. Later on, you can make an Elven one, which transfers more mana. And then this is like the top tier Gaia one, which transfers the most amount of mana. And you can see we need a gold block. So let's get one of those out. And I think one should be enough for now. Just craft it like this. And I will throw this probably right here. And we'll just link these right here. All of them to the same mana spreader, which I'm hoping doesn't overload it. If it overloads it, nothing really happened. You just lose mana. And then we'll grab some coal. I'll just grab about 5 pieces for now, which they probably went into my dank, I'm sure. See, yep, sure enough, they did. And we'll just throw 5 pieces down. Pretty much throw them wherever. And they'll pick them up. So you can see like that, they're picking them up. And you can see right here, it is filling up with mana slowly but surely. And right here we have a function mode and a bind mode. Just make sure it's in bind mode, because if it's in function mode, you can see I can't even shift right click on it. I'm going to sleep through the night and I'll be back once it's daytime. Alrighty, we're back, and there's one thing that you might have found while exploring your world, and those are called Black Lotus. There's black and then there's Blacker Lotus. These ones give you a small amount of mana. You can see right there I have just barely a sliver of it. I throw that in there and it barely goes up any, but if you have a Blacker Lotus, it goes up quite a bit. But just like that, you can see I have just a good amount of mana right there. The first thing that I do want to craft with Botania is a magnet. These ones are great. Really? Well, that's fine. I just got to craft up another one of these and fix this. But yeah, like I was saying, the current magnet I have is, honestly, I think it's better. But the good thing about the Botania magnet is I really don't have to keep preparing it and stuff like that. And as long as I instant break the chest, it's pretty much about the same thing. If you're not gonna instant break the chest and you throw each and every item out, it kind of sucks because there's like a delay until it picks up an item. But for what I use it for, really, it'll be just fine. Alright, and you can see right here, some of the things I'm going to need to craft this is going to be some mana steel. You probably also found some of this in like dungeon chests and whatnot, but if you haven't, one way to craft is you drop an iron ingot into there and you get mana steel. You can drop an ender pearl and you get a mana pearl. This does cost mana to do though. The mana pearls and the mana diamonds cost quite a bit more. In this pack, you're going to have to use a volt diamond, and you put that in there, and then you get a mana diamond. You can see right there, it did drop quite a bit. Currently, I do not need these two right now, but for this mana steel, I did get lucky, and I found quite a bit of it actually while exploring. So what I'm going to do is craft up this mana lens, just like that. I'm going to come over here and craft up the mana lens magnetization, and then we'll come over here and craft the ring of magnetization. I need a magnet, it seems. So what I'll do is, sometimes it's wonky with this system. So we'll come over here and get my lens, and then I know I have a magnet in here. I think you can use some that have been used. I'm not 100% positive on that though. And yeah, you can. So currently this magnet, you can equip it in a bobble slot. You can just right click it like that. And inner arts, you can see I dropped something down and it's not coming to me. Because of that delay, as I was telling you. But right here, say I put this in here. If I break this, then it instantly comes to me. That's what I mean. When, as long as you're going to instantly break the chest, it really isn't too bad. And what I do like about this magnet is, say you had stuff that you threw out, you have that little delay before it comes towards you, and then if you shift with it, the items will not come towards you. So that gives you plenty of time to clear out your inventory and get away from that item without it constantly coming back and clogging your inventory up in the vault. Another thing you can convert using mana is redstone dust into mana powder, which is going to be used for like runes and stuff like that pretty much. You can make special torches with it, but mainly you're going to be using it to craft up runes. And this specific rune we're going to use to craft a pasture seed, or not a pasture seed, I'm sorry, a hopper hawk. And this is going to work as like a vacuum hopper pretty much, which we're going to use to automate this production for living rock and living wood. I'm going to show y'all how to craft up this hopper hawk. You need a rune of air, obviously, and the way to craft that is with one mana powder, mana ingot, carpet, and this stuff right here. So I'm going to get that together and get it all ready to craft with you guys. Alrighty, the next thing that we're going to craft to move towards this hopper hawk is going to be a runic altar, those volt diamond or mana pearl that you used. You can use it to craft this. I typically go with the mana pearl because those are super expensive in this pack. And what you're going to do is you're going to pretty much place it right here. You are going to need another mana spreader. I mean, you could use one of the ones you have, but I'm not going to end up doing that. So we'll come over here and get our gold block. We may even be able to make one from straight from the system, which we can. You'll set this one right next to this mana pool, and you're going to bind it from here to here. All right, and after you've set it down and you've binded your current mana spreader, like I did just to double check it, you're going to come over here, and similar to this, instead of throwing it in though, you're going to right click each and every item. Does not matter the order. You can see right there, it's starting to send mana from our pool. See, this is going to be going down onto this altar, and that's how you craft runes. So with that, we can, after it's all said and done, you're going to throw a piece of living rock on it, just like this, just right on top of it, and you're going to right click with your wand. So you can see it does take a minute with this low tier mana spreader, and that's pretty much what the other ones are meant for. Not only does it transfer mana from your flowers faster, but it also transfers mana onto here quicker. So after it's all said and done, you can see right there it tells you to add a piece of rock, and you right click it if you want, and boom, we have our first rune. This is typically one of the ones that most people make first, because this is used in a lot of different recipes. I don't know what any of these things do though, to be honest. This though is what we're going to use to make Terra Steel, which is way later on down the line, and also the Sojourner Sash. It lets you walk up blocks, kind of like the Volt Hunter variant does, but you cannot walk up fences with that one. The Volt Hunter ones you can. So I typically won't unspec from that, and I don't even make that. Then with this rune, we're going to use it to craft up this hopper hawk, which is going to be a redstone root, which is super simple to make. It's a piece of redstone and either grass or a fern. I probably have everything to make it in here. Do this. Yeah, so I can craft it just like that. We'll throw this in here. We're going to throw this in here, and then we need it. Two gray and two light gray, which thankfully I know we have all of that stuff right in here. That and this. Do that, and then we'll do this. Throw these in here and put a little flower in there. And the way this thing works, it does need mana. I'll show you how to hook that up here in a minute. But if you set it down, I'll put it right here for now. I could throw an item on the ground, and nothing's really gonna happen. But if I do this, this is what the function mode's for. So I can right-click on this, and I can choose to pick up only items not in the frame, and it should pick this block up. Oh, that's right. It does need an inventory to put it into. So I'll get a chest, and I guess I could just put that right there. And let me see. Yeah, and just like that, it picks up that item and goes straight into here. So that's always good. The reason you would want to do the item frame one is because, like, this is so close together right now. If I were to throw coal or a fuel source, it might accidentally pick it up. What's good about it is you can see you can't put it on top of your chest. It has to be on dirt. But the way around that is to actually make a floating thing like this. So you're going to need a pasture seed, which is super simple to make also. Just throw a little bit of grass in here like that. And that gets you your pasture seed. Then you come over here, and it can be any color flower. Does not matter. And, oh, I need a flower in there, actually. So let me get one of those white flowers that I have. We'll throw that in our system, and we'll craft this up. Oh, glimmering white flower. I'm sorry. You get glowstone and put it next to any flower like this. Craft that up. Oh, I need glowstone now. Alrighty, I should be able to craft it now. Yeah, just like that, a glimmering white flower. Come over here and craft this. And then you can put these two things together like that. Floating hopper hawk. And I can now come over here, and I'll just put it here for the time being. Set that on top, and now it can actually put it into this. It can go into pretty much anything, and I would just have to rebind this onto here. And the pickup items only in frame. I'll show you how to do that in item frame. I should have a couple of those, sure do. We have two of those. You can just set them right here on the side, and then you can put your living rock and your living wood in there, and now it'll only pick up those items. So I can throw this down just like this. It won't ever pick that up, but if I throw this down, oh wait, it did pick that up. Maybe the item frames actually have to be on the chest, I believe. Try that one more time. One here and one here. Sorry about this scuffed tutorial, I'm still trying to get used to it. So maybe now it won't pick that up. Let's see. Yeah, so the item frames do have to be on the actual inventory that it's going to be into. But that's how you're going to pretty much automate this here down the line. What you're going to do is just basically, I'll show you guys. Unfortunately, looking at what I need, I'm not going to be able to completely automate it. I will have to still place the box manually because I do not have modular routers installed. But you would, pretty similar to this over here, put a sticky piston down with an iron rod and set it on like a timer. I think it takes a full minute, so you can use like your RF utilities one and set it for that amount of ticks. That every so many ticks it'll go down. I would probably go a little bit over just in case, maybe like a minute and 10 seconds just to hit it, just to completely make sure that they're all done. And then if you did have your modular routers, you can have them below it and have them place a block every minute or so. So that way it'll be completely automated, and this would completely pick it all up. Well, I do hope you guys enjoyed that scuffed intro to Botania. Like I said, I'm not a mod expert or anything like that. Next episode, I have huge plans for what I want to do. I actually want to try and get the pickaxe from Botania. You can see right here. I think it's called, I couldn't tell you off the top of my head right here, the Terra Shatterer. It's pretty, pretty expensive. I'm going to have to get into Dreamwood, and it's going to cost me quite a bit of Volt Diamonds. You can see each one of these takes all of this stuff. So 2 Volt Diamonds each is going to be 18 in total for the blocks, and then another 2 right here, which in total is going to be about 20 Volt Diamonds. I already have a POG. This stuff is just your living wood transferred into a portal, which I'm going to show y'all next episode how to open up. I want to thank each and every one of you guys who have been liking and commenting, such as Giant Turtle. His comment's going to be right there. Valwater, right here, is going to be your comment. Cleo, thank you so much. I see you all the time. And then also Lazy Mode. Y'all are like my main commenters, and I really, really do appreciate that stuff, guys. I really, really do. And currently, we're actually at 61 subscribers, so didn't even realize we passed 50. That's insane. I'm super, super happy about that. Never really actually thought I'd have people willing to watch what I'm putting out here, so that does put a smile on my face, and I want to thank each and every one of you guys. And then also, if you guys aren't subscribed, I think only about 12% of you guys are, please, you know, like, comment, and subscribe. It really does help out a lot, and I really, really do appreciate it, guys. Comment down below it. If you did subscribe, and you will definitely be put in this next video, episode 25, that is. And yeah, thank you guys so much. God bless you guys, and Have a great day.